Kimberly Walsh has the latest spring styles hitting the high street. Before we talk about fashion in a moment, if
yeah,
that's
okay.
all right.
No, that's
because
fine.
You're welcome, by the way. It's lovely
Thank
to see you.
You
so
too.
You were on the red carpet.
I was
for the BAFTAs. So how was it? What sort of goss? What have you got?
Do you know what? It was the weather was so awful. It was pouring down with rain, so everybody was trying to kind of rush inside. But there was some really glamorous looks on the red carpet. I thought Emma Watson looked gorgeous.
Yeah.
Who else looked amazing? Jessica Alba.
Yes, that Nev blue dress
Campbell.
Was gorgeous,
yeah, there was some. It was full-on glamour.
Something about the BAFTAs, which it is, but we were saying earlier on, it always seems to rain on BAFTA night.
Always.
Yeah,
it's rubbish, because all the Americans are over and you're like, oh, I'm sorry, it's but not it quite the same as Hollywood, is
it's
it?
It's very typically British, isn't
yes.
it? So I
you
think
know
it's
that
quite
you're
fitting.
In England,
exactly.
For sure.
Exactly.
So we'll let's hope that the weather is good for when you do your paragliding.
For Comet Relief.
I'm paragliding for Comet Relief.
They make you do some crazy things, Corrie. You've already gone up Kilimanjaro and now you're paragliding.
Holly, it only seems to be Comet Relief that get me doing these crazy things, but Comet Relief have teamed up with Maltesers, and we're just trying to kind of raise awareness, get people to do some fun things for Comet Relief, and then Malteser are going to donate 2p from every pack to Comet Relief.
So when do you do it?
At the end of the month.
Right.
And I really didn't realise how scary it is.
Oh,
so
well, good luck.
Are they sort of training you?
No, I think I'm just going to do it all in the day.
Really?
I know, don't.
Oh, my goodness.
Well, it'll
good
be fun. It'll
it
be
will
fun.
Be fun.
And
it will
hopefully
be fun.
It'll encourage people to do something scary as well.
Cool. OK.
Well, let's get down to a bit of fashion today.
I know, yeah.
Valentine's fashion. What are we starting with, then?
OK, so, obviously, we're looking at looks that women are going to go
like.
For. Yeah, so that's the idea. The first look we've got is Andrew.
Ah.
I believe.
Bringing out the gents.
So this is
very smart.
This is like our spring day look.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And it's all about the tailoring, sort of. Obviously, this is quite a casual look, but you've still got the tailored blazer.
Yeah.
It's like a deconstructed
smart
tailored
casual.
Blazer. And the whole nautical thing
it's
going on.
Got my shirt on underneath that.
Oh, yes.
It's just quite a nice way to wear a blazer because it still seems like you could go out in the day, go shopping in it. Do you know what I mean?
I love a nautical stripe as well. I don't think you can go wrong with that.
Yeah, it's coming back around.
And layering it all up. Gorgeous.
Good.
So the blazer, how much is that?
So the blazer was from M&S and it's $49.50, which is good, I think. And the sweater was from Uniqlo, $12.99.
Gosh,
so that's
good, isn't it?
Bargain. And the boots as well, they're from Giacomo.co.uk and they were £27.
Very good.
Which is really
Do you
good
like?
Thing.
Yes.
Would you wear it?
Yes.
No, not really.
Not really,
no.
But you
but,
like
but, and I think it's very smart. yes, very nice.
No, thank you very much,
really
Andrew.
Good.
Thank
Thanks,
you very much
Andrew.
Indeed.
So, what have we got next?
OK, so this is a more summery look and a summery way to wear sort of tailored clothing. Obviously, he's got the shorts on, but we've still managed to get the blazer in there. And also a little waistcoat, so if you obviously get a little bit hot and you want to take that off, you've still got the sort of smart summer day look.
So once again, we've still got all this sort of layering, haven't we, that we saw in the winter, but actually we were just layering up but with lighter fabrics.
But, I mean, I think in England you have to layer all through the summer as well because you never really know what the weather's going to be like and you want to stay warm.
This is very cute.
It's just kind of, it's a lot smarter than just a T-shirt and shorts,
Yeah.
basically.
So the hat is from River Island.
Yep. And the jacket's from River Island as well, that's $69.99. And the waistcoat is from Topman, £35.
Gosh, they look like they match.
Exactly. And the navies as well are quite easy to wear, I think.
Yeah.
And put with T-shirts and greys and stuff, so.
Shorts and shoes, both from Button. Shorts are £26 and the shoes are £45. Is this the sort of thing that Dan would wear?
Yes and no. I'm not sure he'd do the waistcoat. But I think the shorts, he loves those shoes, definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely
and the shorts,
the
but
shoes.
I think it looks really nice. And it's kind of like that little festival-y chic as well with the little hat.
Exactly.
So
you
I like.
Still feel done and smart. I think it's quite a good look for the summer.
Thank you very much.
Very
thank
good, thank you,
Laurie.
So evening wear.
Evening wear. Okay. Sean, we've got next.
Okay, Sean. Hi, mate.
Okay.
Sean. Very smart.
So this is, this is quite a dapper look, but still. Not as formal as, obviously, a tailored suit. We've got, like, the tailored jacket, but with the jeans to kind of make it a little bit more casual. You've got all the different greys as well and all the different textures in the fabric.
So it's all right that it doesn't
match. It's layering again, yeah.
So it's okay that it doesn't match, because I'd be thinking, oh, no, I'd have to get a jacket that matches with the underneath. But actually, it works,
doesn't
it? I'm
a bit like that as well. I'm tempted to match everything, but I like it. It's like different textures kind of works, and the shirt obviously has got the detail on the collar, so you don't need a tie.
So it's like a double collar there on there. Oh, okay.
It's kind
of
like from
evening look, but
shirts from H&M.
$24.99 from H&M. That looks good. It looks quite trendy, doesn't it?
And the jacket is H&M as well.
And the jacket is $59.99 from H&M. The only thing I don't like, could you lift your arms up for me?
You don't like the pads.
Oh, do you not like that?
Geography teacher.
Oh, no, see, I quite like that.
Do you?
Yeah.
Yeah, I kind of think it makes it a little bit more casual.
I like a bit of that.
And I like the little scarf in the pocket as well. It's just all the little details, I suppose.
Did you have a thing for your geography teacher at school?
No, because it was a woman called Mrs. Grimley, but thanks for asking.
I used to fall asleep in geography.
The cravat is from Tyrak, $19.99. The jeans from Burton at £25, and the shoes are from Loke. Is that how you pronounce
it?
Yes. Yeah. £130 for the shoes.
They're an investment piece, but they're a classic. Mm.
Exactly. You always need a good pair of black.
They're kind of the slightly more trendier churches. Very nice.
I think some women would really go for this look, because it's just a bit cooler than the typical suit.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Every man needs an essential suit.
They do indeed. Brian is wearing it very well, I think.
Oh, you did it very well.
Smart.
Look a bit like Daniel Craig. Just walked into the studio.
I personally do really like a nice suit on a man. Do you?
You cannot beat it.
It's so clean. And obviously this is navy, which I think is quite nice, just a bit of a...
softer as well when you're coming into spring.
You know, you get a little bit bored of black.
So the jacket is from Zara at $89.99.
Yeah, and the trousers too, $39.99. So the suit's from Zara. And the shirt, obviously, you've got the little detail of the buttons.
Yeah.
Which I think is really nice.
So that's a little bit sort of bow tie type of thing, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. It makes it a bit more dressy. Yeah, it's a full-on... You know,
and that's not a bad price, is it? I think that's lovely.
I do. $89.99 for the jacket, yeah. $39.99 for the trousers. Great,
very good.
Isn't it?
Very, very smart.
But
hello,
can I just stop you there, please?
Hello?
This didn't ask what... I didn't ask for this. I'm coming in. I'm not happy. I'm coming in.
We should explain if you've just...
Yeah, you're laughing
over. Thank you
very
much indeed.
Thank you for
that.
Brian.
We should explain if you are just tuning in. We do have a guest editor.
Well, maybe I should explain.
Go on then, explain.
You know those models?
Yes.
I didn't book any of those models. I said get Jedwood to do those. Do you know how much they cost, Jedwood? We've blown our budget on Jedwood.
Sorry.
I want Jedwood in here. I like the clobber, don't get me wrong. But it don't really induce Valentine's Day. Don't say Valentine's, those clothes.
So what would you suggest to sort of epitomise Valentine's Day?
Jedwood. Boys!
I'm
boys!
So sorry.
Here we go, look at this.
Oh, wow.
See, I've actually got this belt, and this is from River Island. I think that costs $19.99. And they look bang tidy, they look really good. Look, they've got no tops on, which means they're ready for loving.
Right.
You don't have to... ladies.
See?
Is that inspired by you?
Yeah. Look at the detail on the shoes. I think you just have black shoes for $129.99. Look at those.
I think
they're about 60 quid. Look at that. Look at that, they've got four print there.
I have to say, they are working it very well.
Well done, lads. Doing me proud.
So that was much better.
Yeah. I'm bang tidy right now.
See?
He's like one businessman of the year.
93.
Yes. That was the idea that you
Henson
wanted.
That's what I wanted.
Thanks, guys.
I don't want to be on camera now.
Well, go back to the gallery.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Jedward, as always.
If you missed any of that, or indeed you want more on Keith's styling, then you can find the details on our webpage. It's itv.com/.
Still come if you've